In this video, we'll show you how to make some basic GET requests from something other than a browser. We will be using the free tool Fiddler to demonstrate this. Since Fiddler is able to support multiple platforms, we'll be using Fiddler to showcase certain features of the PyWeb API, rather than focusing on a specific language. When developing your application, it's very useful to test out certain HTTP requests to confirm they're returning the results and headers that you expect. Fiddler allows us to rule out any language-specific problems that may be showing up. Fiddler is traditionally used as an HTTP debugging proxy server application. It's used to capture HTTP and HTTPS traffic and logs it for you to interpret and dissect. In our case, we want to compose HTTP requests to the PyWeb API, so we'll disable capture traffic. To compose an HTTP request, we can select the Composer tab here. As you can see, we can select one of the many HTTP request verbs and enter the URL we want to connect to. In this case, we'll be using the PyWeb API endpoint. We can specify the HTTP protocol version as well as add in the HTTP headers and compose a body for the request if need be. So let's test out submitting a basic HTTP request. We'll use a GET request, and we'll use the main PyWeb API landing page for the URL and hit execute. On the left-hand side, we see we have a new entry in our log. We've gotten a 401 response. To further investigate this response, we can select it, which will automatically bring us to the Inspectors tab. In the response, we see we have a 401, which corresponds to unauthorized access denied. In our case, since we're using Kerberos authentication, it's expecting some kind of authentication method to be included with our request, so let's apply that information. If we specify the authorization in the request header, we should be able to solve the issue. Back in the Composer tab, Fiddler allows us to implement integrated security to our request quite easily by selecting the Automatically Authenticate checkbox under the Options tab in the Composer. If we hit execute again, we should expect to see a good 200 response now that we've supplied the proper authorization with our request. Looking at the logs, we see the response does in fact have a 200 header, and now we can take a look at the response. The response is in JSON, and we see it's the same as what we would see in a browser. Now that we've successfully submitted a GET request and confirmed this is properly working, let's try and get something a little more useful. For example, I want to get some information about a particular attribute. Let's take a look at the NewGreen database. Let's say I wanted to find the fuel gas flow attribute for the boiler B210 element. Now, our job is to construct our URL within Fiddler that we can use to get this information on this attribute. If we navigate through the browser, we eventually arrive at this endpoint for this particular attribute. Though we don't want to navigate to the browser every time we want to find out what the URL we need to reach is, so let's take a look at the help files to see if we can construct our Web API endpoint for this information more easily. For information on the attribute, we likely want the attribute controller. Looking at the possible actions, it seems like get by path is the action we want, since we know the name of the AF server, AF database, element path, and attribute name. The help file indicates that we want to use a get request to the attribute's controller endpoint. It also indicates that if we want to use the get by path action, we'll need to use the path URL parameter. Looking at the syntax information for this in that Web API help files, it looks like we can build this information out. Going back to Fiddler, we can put this information in the URL and make a request to the attribute's endpoint. take off the web ID from this URL in the entry box already, and then use ?path to add the URL parameter. Then we'll type in the path, including the attribute name, to the attribute of interest. You'll notice that the URL highlighted bright red there. This is because cracking process, part of the path name, has a space in it. Spaces aren't allowed in URLs. We need to replace this with a %20, the URL encoding for space. Any breaking characters need to be replaced with URL encoding, such as spaces. Once we've done this, we can execute the request and see that we have a good response. We can see that the JSON information is the same as what is returned in the browser. We can see the path is correct, as well as the name of the attribute. From the list of links, we can find the link to the value for the attribute. If we copy and paste this in as our new GET request, we can execute this request and see the response of the most recent value for this attribute. You'll notice from the link that we're using the long web ID format to get the value for this attribute. In addition to the snapshot value for this attribute, we can also get the recorded value for this attribute. Let's take a look at the list of actions on the attributes controller. We see there's a getValue action, but we don't see any actions for getting recorded or getting multiple values. This getMultiple action is for getting multiple attributes. So let's go back and take a look at the URL that's being made for that request in Fiddler. We see the getRecordedData is actually hitting the streams controller, rather than the attribute controller. So let's take a look at the streams controller in the help file. Here, we can see that we have a getRecorded action. Let's take a closer look at it. If we select this action, we can see that we should use a GET request, and that we'll need the web ID of the attribute. Additionally, we have a couple of optional URL parameters, such as the start time and the end time. If you recall from earlier, the start time defaults to one day ago, and the end time defaults to now. So let's build a request in Fiddler for the recorded value to this attribute. We've already got the streams endpoint correctly set, so now we just need to change the action from value to recorded. We'll use that ?? for a URL parameter, and we'll specify 2 hours ago. We'll leave the end time blank because we want it to go until now, which is the default behavior. When we execute this response, we see there's only one value for the past 2 hours for this attribute. If we try for the past 4 hours, we should see more values. In this video, we introduce Fiddler, a tool that allows us to make HTTP calls to the Pi Web API to test our calls independent of code. We explored making basic GET requests specifically to the home page. We also briefly touched on authorization, a topic we'll go over more in depth in a later video, as well as HTTP response codes. We used the help documentation to build a more complex GetByPath call to attributes and used URL parameters to help specify what information we want from that query. You're now well on your way to using the PyWeb API.